Hi, I'm Alfred Bundy here in Atlantic City at the New Jersey League of Municipality Convention for our special coverage brought to you by Altice USA. Now joining me is State Senator Anthony Bucco. How are you doing?
Pretty good. How are you?
You know, we got to reflect here for just a second before we go any further. Talk to us a little bit about the loss of your father who left us not that long ago.
Well, it was a big loss, obviously, for me personally, for my family. You know, I had the privilege of working with my dad every day. So in one sense, I was blessed, right? There's not many parent and children that work together every day. There are not many that spent 10 years on the floor of the legislature together. So those are moments that I'll always cherish.
But now, we certainly know about the Kane family. Has there been any other like son and father?
Well, Allison McCose was there while her dad was there. There's been a few over
there's
the years.
Okay.
But I think my father and I had a pretty long running term in both the Assembly and the Senate.
Talk to us about what this did on the organizational side, from political side, because what happened? There was a special election. Explain how you actually took over your father's seat.
As a result of my father's untimely passing, that created a vacancy in the Senate. I was in the middle of running for my Assembly seat because it was during that election cycle, so I had to make a decision. And I chose to follow in my father's footsteps. There was a convention. The Republican Party chose me to fill his seat in the Senate. I was honored about that. And then I had to, because of the timing of that, it was too late to remove me from the ballot. There were already thousands of people that had voted by absentee. We didn't want to disenfranchise anybody. So I had to continue and run for that Assembly seat at the same time. And thankfully, the voters of my district felt that it was important to keep that seat in Republican hands, and they elected me to the Assembly, which will be filled tomorrow night, actually, in a convention similar to my convention to run in the to become a senator.
Okay. Thank you for that background. We did need a little bit more perspective. Certainly our condolences to you and your family. What's going on as far as this vaping, e-cigarettes? Are y'all looking at legislation or trying to do something? Because this is all of a sudden kind of caught fire, and we see it's really hurting a lot of people.
There are a series of bills, package of bills now in the legislature. In fact, it was in our committee the other day that would further regulate the vaping in the state of New Jersey. It is a serious issue. We are seeing many becoming sick as a result of the vaping process. So this is something that is serious. It's got to be addressed by the legislature, and I think we will. I think those bills will make it to the floor, and I'm sure they'll get to the governor's desk.
Sports betting has taken off. It has kind of like revived Atlantic City. It's really hot in the Meadowlands and a number of the racetracks. Tell me where you are with this sports betting. Is something you want to, and what happens with that money once it comes back?
Well, look, I think that sports betting was a great improvement here in Atlantic City. It's done great things for this city. You know, it's also brought in a lot of revenue to the state of New Jersey, cover some of the horse racing industry, which needed some help. So, look, anytime that we can get some additional revenue like that, it's a good thing. I think we need to keep our eye on it, make sure that the revenue continues to grow, and we continue to promote it.
One of the questions I'm asking everybody, what are we losing or gaining with having Donald Trump in the White House?
Well, look, I mean, you certainly have done extremely well on your 401k. There's nobody that can say the stock market and the economy hasn't really taken off over these last few years. There is some division amongst the electorate, which is never a good thing. I think we need to continue to work to bring people together and to find common goals. You know, there's not an awful lot. There's more that unites us than divides us. And we need to continue to concentrate on what unites us rather than what divides us.
Before we go, under executive order, the governor's trying to put together something called a state public bank. Good idea, bad idea?
I'm already on record of this. I think it's a disaster. Government has never been good at running something that the private sector can already. I think we need to stay out of the banking industry. I think the taxpayers will be left holding the bag if we get in on it.
Mm. State Senator, I want to thank you for joining us here in Atlantic City. I'm Alfred Bundy for Altice USA.